Forget absolutely everything you have learned about the RSI. What you have been told is irrelevant at best and might as well be thrown in the garbage. The RSI is in fact the most powerful tool you can use within technical analysis. Here's how you really use it, but brace yourself, you are about to learn everything there is to know about the best kept secret within the trading community. The RSI, or Relative Strength Index, is perhaps the most misunderstood and overly simplified indicator of them all. One that, in fact, contains a plethora of dimensions to whomever is willing to go beyond what first meets the eye. For all people seem to see is a rabbit hole, and all they allow themselves to see is a rabbit hole. They know it probably contains bunnies, but not how many or where they are heading. Surely they sometimes see bunnies coming and going, but they don't know when, from where, or why. The same goes for the RSI. Traders look at the RSI, yet they see little more than crumbles. In this trilogy, you will be introduced to a mighty rich world that few traders even know exists. As this is a vastly deep and complex topic, and a very technical and quite difficult one too, I have decided to turn this very important message into 3 episodes. All for the sake of simplicity. And I really recommend you to watch all 3 as they together paint a full picture of an otherwise difficult concept. In this episode, the first out of 3, we will discuss how the RSI is misunderstood and not used to its fullest potential. Not even nearly. It's an important introduction to better understand what the RSI really is. The second episode is the main one. In that one, we will discuss in full how you really use the RSI, how you properly use it, and how incredibly strong it really is. The content in that episode might very well be the most valuable trading information you have yet to come across on YouTube. In the third episode of this trilogy, we will go over a rich variety of examples to demonstrate the techniques and to further help you learn them properly. The fascinating thing about the RSI is that very few traders, even professionals, seem to know about its secrets, despite the very fact that they're all hidden in the open air. In fact, to this day, I have personally yet not come across a single trader who knows about what I'm about to outline in detail in this trilogy. Now, when you listen to traders talking about the RSI, it's all from a strictly two-dimensional perspective. They look at divergences and they look at 70 for overbought and 30 for oversold. But what exactly are they meant to do with that information? Surely it comes in handy every now and then, but whatever they see is surface level stuff. For they still only see the rabbit hole and they have no clue whatsoever how many bunnies are actually in the hole and where they are heading. Let us delve deeper into this two-dimensional perspective for a bit in order to clarify what the traditional and unsatisfactory RSI interpretations mean. Let's begin with the divergence. Now, a divergence doesn't necessarily mean prices will reverse, as one too many traders seem to believe. It literally means prices could do either of the following 2 scenarios. 1, prices could go down, or 2, prices could go up. Okay, wow. That helped a lot, thanks. You're welcome. As stupid as this may sound, it is exactly why the RSI more often than not turns into guesswork and noise when used in the traditional old way. This is why any typical surface level RSI usage is pretty much useless. Let us further discuss this in order to fully understand it. In the first case, when the RSI divergence means prices will go down, the RSI signifies a weakened strength in the buyer-seller dynamics, as in prices go up but with less power. For sustainable upwards movements need to be propelled with power, and this power is also seen in and measured by the RSI. Compare this to throwing a rock into the air with your bare arm, as opposed to blowing one into the sky with a bazooka. Which one will make it the farthest? Exactly, the bazooka, because it has much more throwing power than your arm. In the second case, however, as prices continue up, the RSI divergence constitutes nothing else but a power amassing pit stop, a way for the buyers to catch their breath in order to sprint again. With regards to RSI divergences, the same of course applies in reverse for downward movements too. So, how then do you know what a divergence really means? How should you act upon that RSI information? Are prices ready to reverse, or are they simply amassing new strength for another continuation move? This is the type of dilemmas you are faced with once you put money on the line and reality doesn't pan out the way it does in promising trading literature. The same literature or trading videos on YouTube where trading is presented as something easy and straightforward. In reality, the basic RSI usage taught in trading literature or YouTube tutorials still works, at least partially. It's your job as a trader to distinguish whether the RSI constitutes a likely reversal or another continuation to come. And as with everything within technical analysis, it needs to be looked at in a contextual way, where each indicator or signal is a piece of a puzzle rather than a rigid picture. But just because all murderers wear gloves doesn't mean everyone who wears gloves is a murderer. The simple answer is that the longer and stronger a divergence is, as in more peaks over an extended time, the more likely it is to be a signal. And as always, any indicator or signal tends to be more reliable when looked at from a more zoomed out perspective. In this sense, a one-month chart will always, always present more signals in relation to noise than a one-minute chart will. But a key thing to remember about technical analysis is that no situation will ever be 100%. For even if every single indicator and every support and resistance line perfectly align for an upwards movement, prices can still go down. This is also one of the reasons why technical analysis is so difficult, because it's discretionary. Show a graph to 10 technical analysts and you will likely get 10 somewhat different interpretations and conclusions, whereof one will be the most correct one and one will be the least correct one, and the remaining 8 will fall on a gradual scale in between. My point is that RSI divergences to some extent are overrated. They're literally everywhere and you won't have a hard time finding one on any random chart. But most importantly, they are discretionary, and if you cannot begin to tell the overall strength of the equity without the RSI, an RSI divergence of any sort will not provide you with signals. It will provide you with confusion and noise. The mathematical reason why there is an RSI divergence prior to most new price tops or bottoms to begin with is because it would otherwise eventually reach and surpass 100 or 0 respectively, which of course is impossible. Just like no number-based additions or multiplications can ever reach infinity, neither can an RSI ever reach 0 or 100. Technically, you can still reach an RSI of 1 or 99, or even 0.1 or 99.9, but you will never ever reach the polar extreme values of 0 or 100. This is why RSI divergences are such frequent occurrences, even in trending markets, and something that surely tricks unknowing traders into selling or taking shorts. Now, enough about the RSI divergence. Let us instead proceed to the other part of how technical traders don't extract full value from this incredible indicator. Anyone who is at least somewhat familiar with technical analysis knows that analysts like to talk about the RSI being oversold and overbought. And yes, so far that statement is true. What is also true is that just like divergences are discretionary, so are the overbought and oversold levels. When I first started out trading myself, I would often use the RSI levels of 30 and 70 as sold buying and selling triggers, as if they were rare occurrences. This sounds incredibly stupid now, and rightfully so, and of course I lost money through my nose. And having been a Londoner for 8 years, stuff coming out of the nose is in stark contrast to the London culture, where nose-related things usually go the other direction. Not me though, I still value my brain cells and dignity. The point is that just because an RSI level is overbought or oversold, as in below 30 or above 70, doesn't at all mean it cannot stay overbought or oversold for extended periods of time. Quite the opposite. Any trending market rather tends to stay in those territories, and as the RSI remains in these misrepresentedly toxic territories, prices often continue to rally when the RSI is overbought and plummet when it's oversold. Just look at this chart in fingerprint cards. In this case, the RSI remained oversold for a good part of 3.5 months, and all the while the price decreased by almost 60%. Another example in the very same stock is how the RSI overwhelmingly remained in overbought territory for an incredible 5 months. During this period, the price increased by more than 500%. How is that for overbought, and how was the previous one for oversold? These examples more than well prove my point here, and you can find these types of examples in pretty much any equity. Of course, professional traders know better than to put too much weight on the overbought versus oversold RSI levels and on RSI divergences alone. They are merely minor components, pieces of a puzzle, if you may, that each add to any technical picture at hand. And whilst the RSI does aid them, they still miss out on massive levels of value, like driving a car without knowing how to gear it. Now, let's instead discuss how to make full use of the RSI dynamics. For rather than the RSI being a rusty Skoda with a broken gearbox, it can be a 7G-tronic Mercedes. A fat, comfortable Mercedes that takes you all the way down to Wonderland. To sum up this first episode, the RSI is a complex yet incredibly valuable indicator, one that few traders seem to have understood how to make proper use of. Instead, they carry their water in strainers, and while seasoned traders think they know how to use the RSI, they in fact extract little value at best, whereas inexperienced traders lose money because they simply haven't understood even the basics. These are the traders that automatically sell or take short positions whenever the RSI reaches overbought territories of 70 or more. But RSI divergences and overbought and oversold levels are nothing else but surface level usage. For what exactly are you meant to do with that information, as prices sometimes reverse and other times don't? This is why we need to go deep and learn how to properly use it. So stay put for the next episode, perhaps the most important technical analysis episode you will ever get to watch.